and welcome to How to Create a OneNote Class Notebook. Now, if you're wondering what on earth is a OneNote Class Notebook, then you probably need to take a look at the previous video, which outlines what OneNote Class Notebook is, what OneNote is, and some of the features and why it would be potentially a good thing for using when remote teaching. So let's get started. And the first step that we're going to do is head on over to your email through Connect and click on the waffle. And you don't want to go to OneNote, you want to go to Class Notebook. OneNote is to access the notebooks, but Class Notebook is the management tool for setting up your class notebooks. So it's thinking about it for a second. And we click on this one, Create a Class Notebook. And I'm going to give it a name. So this is going to be for my Year 8 Digital Technologies 2020 Semester 1. I click Next. This tells us all of those features that it's going to have, the collaboration space, the content library, and the student notebooks. Click Next. Now, if you want to give another teacher permission, then you'd add their email address in here. This would be good if you've got an EA in the class or you're just team teaching or any of these sorts of reasons. I don't have anyone, so I'm going to leave that at the moment. But here's the trick. Student names. Now, it would be a really annoying thing to have to type in all of those student names. Luckily, we can go and get them from DAM. There's an earlier video on how to get student email addresses from DAM. There's one thing though, it's the student email addresses in DAM, and I've combined all my classes into this one sheet. The student email addresses in DAM don't have a semicolon after them, and all of the OneNote ones, need to be separated by a semicolon. Now that's going to be a bit annoying to have to go and type in a semicolon. Luckily, I've created a tool for you to do just that. So if you go to Connect and down to the Corrine Senior High School community, and then head on over when it loads to Content, and go to Online Delivery How-To Guides and scroll to the OneNote section. There's a tool here called DAM to OneNote Student Email Conversion Tool. And all this does is places a semicolon. So if I go back to my DAM list, and I'm going to grab all of my students there, and I'm going to pop them into my DAM to OneNote Student. And you can see now that this column B has got the email addresses but with a semicolon. I'm just going to copy 10 to 15 email addresses at a time because OneNote seems to be in the department, seems to be having some difficulties because of high usage. But I'm going to copy those first 15 and I'm going to paste them. Has a little spin while it thinks about it, and then they come up like this. They're got underlines, so they've what we call resolved. They've searched for them in the school management system and found them. So again, I'm just going to go and get the next set. So I've done those first 15. I'm now going to do 15 to 30. In normal circumstances, you could probably paste the whole list just fine, but right now it's just having a little bit of difficulty. So let's just go get my next lot. And it's thinking about it. Okay, so all of our email addresses have resolved. Just took a minute. I now click on Next. And this gives me what sections are going to be in each student's notebook. I tend not to have them set up as those names. I tend to have just two sections, classwork, which is where they put all of their notes and things that we work on in class, and then one for assessments. And then each assessment's generally one page, and each classwork section, I might have a subsection, or I might distribute a whole section for a piece of work. But as a general rule, I just have the two. But you might just want to think about how you're going to structure it, because this will be the default for every student. I now click next, and you get a preview of what it will look like. So this is what it will look like for me. I can see all of the students, and this is what it will look like for the student. They can only see themselves. Okay, and now I click create. Okay, and that has finished and reloaded my page. And it's actually sent me an email as well to let me know that my class notebook has been created and that I've in fact been added to it. So I can choose to open it in OneNote, the application, or to open it in OneNote online. I find it easier to just get my students to use the online version, so they're only needing to worry about one location and they don't need to worry about syncing, but really it's up to you. So I'm going to grab the open it in OneNote online. So you automatically get a welcome page, and it gives you some links to go and do further training. And each of the students also get a welcome page about how to use their notebook and their FAQ and some videos on how to use it. And it's customized for being a student as opposed to being a teacher. Now, one feature that is not available during the setup but is really good to have is the teacher only space. So if you go back to your management, and we will actually completely click on class notebook again. I could have done back to home. And this time I'm going to manage my notebooks. Okay, you can see all of the notebooks that I have. I've got quite a few set up here. So I'm going to go and find my Year 8 Digital Technologies 2020-1 that I just created. And the thing I want to enable is enable the teacher only section or group. And this will give you another little section in yours. I'll show you in a second where you can create content that the students can't see. So while you're preparing it and getting it ready to go, this is a great place to have it. And then you can distribute it from here into your students' notebooks or put it into the content section. The other thing that you can do in here is determine whether or not you want the collaboration space locked or unlocked. I generally find it's a good idea to have it locked in the first instance, and you can always come and unlock it any time that you need to. The other option in here is collaboration space permissions. You can actually set up so that you can have sections within your collaboration space and only certain students have access to each section. So this is good for small group work. You can enable the parent and guardian links, so it would enable parents to be able to access it. I'm not sure whether that has actually been enabled from our IT and network management side, but if it is, this is where you can turn it on and off for your individual notebooks. And you can get a link to the actual notebook. So let's flick back and see what my teacher only space looks like. I need to refresh my page so that it will show up. There we go. Now I have this teacher only section. And if I click in there, it also gives me some further information and details about how I can use the space using the teacher only space. You can also go to your content library, and it's got some information there about how to use the content library, and there's information in the collaboration space about how to use the collaboration space. So they try to make it very easy for you with the how-to bits and pieces. You can also see, if we go into my student's notebook, there's my assessment section and my classwork section. Unfortunately, it does come with a blank page in each one. So then when you distribute this, the blank page will still be there. So if I did want to distribute some content to my students, I am going to want to get that content from somewhere to begin with. So let's say I'm going to my teacher only space. I'm going to create a new page. And let's say this is binary encoding. So I've got a video and I've got some work here. And perhaps I might have some questions that I want students to answer as they're watching the videos. Now, how do they know that I want them to answer those questions? I like to use a table, so insert a table. I do four. What is binary encoding? I'm going to pop that in there. And numbers and set this up. So now students are able to enter their answers in there. I like to usually make the question bold as well, just to make sure it stands out. Probably would be helpful to put some instructions for exactly what you're wanting them to do. Watch the video and then answer the questions below, etc., etc. So now if I'm ready to do that, I would go to Class Notebook, Distribute Page, and I can click to distribute the page to everyone in the book, everyone in the class. I can do individual distribution if I just wanted to go to one or two, one student, or group distribution if I want to choose which students get it, and cross notebook distribution. So if I've got multiple classes, I can distribute to whichever other class from my one class notebook. So I'm just going to go with distribute page at the moment. And I can click on the section where I want it to go. This is just some classwork. And I will click distribute. And that will think about it for a while. And then it would come up in the classwork section for every student once it is completed. Good luck, and let me know if there's anything else that I can be more clear about.